Good evening, everyone. Here we go. Today is precisely going to be the last video in Macaulay's technique, and this is going to be the final case where there is a couple acting at a certain point, let's say 4 meters away from this simply support. How to work out the slope equation, how to work out the deflection equation, all of that and much more coming up in today's session. So keep watching right till the end. As always, the first step in any problem based on deflection of beam is to work out the reaction at supports. Kaise karenge usko? Let's say that the reaction over here be represented by RA, and this, let's say, is represented by RB. Okay, so let's first of all try to work out the reactions and then we can get going. So that's the problem. EI has been given to us. This is in kilonewton meter square, right? So everything is in kilonewtons, no conversions whatsoever. Loads are also in kilonewtons. This EI product is also given in kilonewton, right? So the first thing, consider that beam. Obviously, these two loads, not loads, but reactions are acting in the upward direction and this one in the downward direction. So what we have is that summation of all the forces in the y direction is equal to zero, and based on that philosophy, you've got RA and RB in the upward direction and 300 in the downward direction minus 300 is equal to zero. So what you have is an equation in RA and RB. So RA plus RB is equal to 300. Let's say this is our equation number one, right? Another thing which you need to know is that you need to apply the moment equation. How to apply the moment equation? Just watch this. Moment about point A, let's say, is equal to zero. How to apply this? With respect to this point, you have to take the moment is equal to zero. So the first thing is RB. It is anti-clockwise. Obviously, this is the force and this is the distance, perpendicular distance. As it is anti-clockwise, you have to take a positive sign. This is going to be 6 times of RB. Then if you watch, you have put a point load over here. So this is acting in the clockwise sense, 300 multiplied by this 4. So minus of 300 into 4, and then you've obviously got a couple. This couple is sort of acting in a clockwise sense, and that's why you have to take it as negative. That's the protocol which I have been following. Okay. So that is 150, and all of this is going to be 0. Just try to work it out. So RB will work out as, dekhte hain kitna aata hai, RB 300 times of 4 is 1200 plus 150, all of that over to the right hand side, okay? So 1350 divided by 6, so 1350 divided by 6 will get you, let me just check, 1350 divided by 6 will get you 225 precisely. So RB has been worked out as 225 kilonewtons. And when you plug in the value of RB in this equation, so you'll have RA is equal to 300 minus 225. RA will be equal to 300 minus 225. That is going to be 75 kilonewtons. So these are essentially the values of RA and RB which we've got. Now let's proceed. Right? So you can essentially replace these two. I mean, just rub this and write these stuff. 75 over here and 25 here. Now let us try to frame the moment equation. So you need to take a section. In order to take the section, you need to pick an origin, and as always, the leftmost end of the beam, I usually choose this as the origin, the leftmost portion of the beam, and from here I'll take a section where, to be very precise, here. Let's take this section. Okay, now let me make only this much portion of the beam, and let us try to work out how many forces are acting on it. That's the beam. Here we go. So whenever you take the section from the left, what you have, that's clockwise, mx, this distance is obviously x, you know that. What is this? This is RA, and RA's value, well, this is 75. So let me just write this over here, 75 kilonewton. Apart from that, there is this point load. What is the magnitude? You know that. How much? 300 kilonewtons, and then there is this couple. So what is the magnitude of the couple? That's 150 kNm. So these are essentially all the forces and moments acting on this x portion of the beam, okay? And you know very well, this is 4. Now how to frame the moment equation? You need to pick a point about which moment has to be equated to 0. So let's say this is that point about which moment is going to be 0. When you do that, first of all, let me just write this. What have we just done? We have taken the section between. What are those points? Section between kis se beech mein liya? C and B with A as origin. C and B with A as origin. With A as origin. Now let's begin. And what we shall try to do is that we are going to do this moment. Moment is equal to zero. About which point? This is that point about which moment has to be equated to zero. So just take a look at this. Mx anticlockwise. So a positive sign. Simply just write Mx. And then you've got this. 75 multiplied by x. 75 multiplied by x. Clockwise moment. Therefore a negative sign. Minus of 75 multiplied by x. Then you've got this point load. 300 multiplied by this distance. Can you just tell me how much this distance is going to be? Fairly simple. This over here, this distance, this small distance over here, this is nothing but x minus 4. Just try to think about this. This much is x, out of which if you subtract this portion, then this is obviously going to be x minus 4. So, anticlockwise, positive sign, 300 times of x minus 4. So, this is going to be, since it is anticlockwise, positive sign plus, okay, let's do this, 300 times of x minus 4. What about the couple? So, you have a couple over here. That is 150 kNm. Okay, just think about this. What is the nature? Clockwise. So, according to our protocol, our sign convention, clockwise, we put a negative sign. Magnitude is 150. How far is this couple? X minus 4 distance. But we only multiply force by perpendicular distance to get the moment. But why are we doing this for a couple? Because we want to make it a function of x. So what we'll do is, we'll multiply this by x minus 4 because this couple is acting at a distance of x minus 4. But you just have to put 0 over here. Okay, so the equation is still balanced. Anything to the power 0 is what? It is equal to 1. This is a technique which has to be followed only during the Macaulay's approach and nowhere else, right? So all of this stuff is going to be 0. Or just try to remember these things whenever you come across a couple while writing the moment equation, especially in case of deflection of beams. Even when you take the couple into the equation, you have to multiply it with the distance, how far it is from the point of taking the moment. But that distance has to be equated to this, but has to be taken to this power 0. Remember all these things. Only make sure that this thing has been done for the couple. And now things are going to get very easy. We know very well that mx is nothing but ei y double dash, and that's equal to, let me just frame this in a better fashion, all of this sign is going to change, okay? So this is going to be 75x separation line plus 300 times of x minus 4, not plus, this is plus, this is minus, and this minus will become plus 150 times of x minus 4. Now the entire thing lies on integrating. We are going to integrate it once to get the slope equation and then integrating again to get the deflection equation. How? Well, here it is. So when you integrate this, you're going to get a result like this. Y double dash will become y dash. This is going to be equal to 75 x square over 2 with first constant of integration c1, then a separation line, minus 300 times of x minus 4 whole square, all of this divided by 2, plus 150 times of x minus 4 to the power, it was 0, so that is going to become 0 plus 1 upon 0 plus 1, isn't it? So x minus 4 to the power 1 divided by 1. That's it. So this is going to be your slope equation. Now, when you integrate this again, you are going to get the deflection equation. Niche likhe kya? Ki idhar likhe? Let's write it over here. Let's make some space first of all. Right, here we go. On integrating this again, e I y dash will become e I y, and that's equal to, let's, x cube by 6, isn't it? 75 x cube by 6. So this is going to be 75 x cube by 6. This c1 will also get integrated. It will become plus c1x with a new constant of integration c2, and then we are going to have a separation line. This separation line is for this, you can say. If you are before this c, then obviously only this much portion will be considered. Once you are beyond c, to the right of c, then all of this stuff has to be considered. All of this stuff, right? And here we go, x minus 4 power 3 divided by 6, 3 2 is 6, and minus 300 x minus 4 and to the power 3 divided by 6. Just take a look. Plus 150 x minus 4 power 2 divided by 2. Plus 150 x minus 4 power 2 divided by 2. And that's it. So these are essentially the raw forms of the slope and deflection equation. So what we need to do now is to get the value of C1 and C2 to get the final form. Okay, much more refined form. How to do that? Well, that can essentially be done by applying the boundary conditions. And now let me just take you through that. Boundary conditions. So if you have been following my videos, you know very well what those boundary conditions are, and especially for this simply supported beam. Just compress this x. Okay, you're right here, bang here. That is at x is equal to 0. What you have? Deflection is 0. You know very well, for a simply supported beam at both the endpoints, starting as well as ending, that is at A as well as B, okay, at the end supports, the deflection is 0. So x is equal to A, y is 0, ya is 0. At x is equal to 6, yb is going to be 0. That's pretty simple. When you do that, when you apply this boundary condition, where is our deflection equation? 0, 0, 0, c2 is left. 0 minus 4 is minus 4, discard. 0 minus 4 is minus 4, discard. Right? So that's it. C1, not C1, but C2's value is going to work out as 0. Now guys, in the same manner, you can apply another boundary condition, and that states that at x is equal to 6 meters, what you have is the deflection at B, that is the rightmost end support, and that is going to be equal to 0. Now you need to know, you need to work with a bit of mathematics. Now let us plug in all the values. X is equal to 6. So EIY, this term over here, 0, is equal to 75x cube. 75 into x cube, that is 6 cube divided by 6, done. Plus 6 times of C1, done. Plus C2. C2 is what? C2 is 0, okay. That has already been worked out. And then obviously minus 300. Oh, so what's x? So we are keeping x as 6, 6 minus 4 cube divided by 6, okay, plus 150 times of x minus 4, that is 6 minus 4 power 2, all of that divided by 2. You just need to solve this equation and get the value of c2. C2, let me tell you, zara dekhte hain, equation sahi banaye ki nahi, 75 x cube by 6, c1 x c2 300 x minus 4 by 6, theek hai. Plus 150 x minus 4 square by 2, theek hai. So all of this values, when you plug it in, you're going to get the value of C2, not C2, you're going to get the value of C1 rather, minus 433.33. So that is the value of C1, right? So let us convert these raw slope and deflection equations into their refined forms. Kaise karna hai? Dikhate hain karke aapko. To red se likhte hain yaar isko, chalo. Slope. If I were to write the slope equation would be something like this, EI y double dash. Okay, EI y double dash is equal to, here we go, 75 x square by 2. 75 by 2 is 37 ka 74, 37.5. So this is going to be 37.5 x square plus C1. How much is C1? C1 is minus 433.33. Anything else? So you've got this separation line done. Minus 300 by 2 is 150. Minus 150. How much x minus 4 to the power 2? Done. Plus 150 x minus 4. Plus 150 times of x minus 4. So this essentially, this over here, This is what you call the equation of slope. Now let me tell you what the deflection equation is, and you just need to plug in the value over there. It's very simple. Let me just tell that EIY is equal to 75x cubed by 6. So 75 by 6, 6 kam 6 15 bacha, 6 duni 12, 3 bacha, 6 panje 30, 12.5. This is going to be 12.5x cube minus 433.33x, C2 is 0, you know that. And then you have a separation line, minus 300 by 6 is 50, 6 panje 30, this is going to be 50x minus 4 power 3 plus 150 by 2 is 75, and that's 75 times of x minus 4 to the power 2. So this is going to be your deflection equation. Okay, the final deflection equation. Thoda samman de dete hain. Here we go. Done. Finally, what we need to calculate is this. Find the deflection at C. Okay, for finding the deflection at C, it's quite easy. Let's start this deflection at C. So if you are supposed to find a deflection at C, that means you are this way. Okay, that means at x is equal to 4, the deflection has to be worked out. So at x is equal to 4 meters. Okay, so how are we going to work out the deflection? You just need to put this value into this equation, and automatically you are going to get the deflection. But first of all, let me check the balance. Okay, the value of EI is being given in kilonewton meter square, and that kilonewton meter square, if you just take a look at the LHS, and let me check RHS. What is the unit of LHS? If the units do not match, then we need to do some kind of conversion. EIY, the unit is kilonewton meter square multiplied by this Y. Y is also in meters, so this is going to be kilonewton meter square into meter. So this is kilonewton meter cube, you can see. And then as far as RHS is concerned, all of this has been initially done using kilonewtons, right? You take a look at this deflection equation. This is kilonewtons. Kilonewton x to the power 3, that means it is kilonewton x to the power 3, that means kilonewton meter cube. Here also we have meter cube, kilonewton, kilonewton. So the equation is perfectly balanced. You just need to plug in the value of EI over here and it's done, right? फिनिश करते हैं फटाफट, बस कैलकुलेशन बचा है. हियर वी गो. ओके, कितना है 8 × 10⁴, 8 × 10⁴ किलोन्यूटन मीटर स्क्वायर. परफेक्ट. वेयर आर वी फाइंडिंग द डिफ्लेक्शन? डिफ्लेक्शन एट सी, एंड दिस इज गोना बी इक्वल टू 12.5 एक्स क्यूब मतलब 4 to the power 3 माइनस 433.33 times of x. How much is x? It's 4. Okay, so even if you put the value of x is equal to 4 into this much portion, this expression and this expression, 4 minus 4 will be automatically 0. Don't have to worry about that. Only when you go beyond this portion, when the value of x is more than 4, only then these two terms will come into the picture. Otherwise not. You just need to simply solve this equation to get the value of y. Y at C will work out as, let me make a check. पहले तो मीटर्स में आएगा माइनस 0.0116, माइनस 0.0116, दिस इज इन मीटर्स. इफ यू ट्राई टू डू अ कन्वर्जन, एंड लेट मी जस्ट राइट दिस, 11.6 मिलीमीटर्स, एंड दिस नेगेटिव साइन पर्टेन्स टू अ डिफ्लेक्शन इन द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन, एंड दैट्स इट गाइस. दैट्स एग्जैक्टली व्हाट वाज नीडेड टू बी डन. So yeah, these were the 5 examples with which I'm pretty much sure that you can solve any problem based on Macaulay's technique. Go ahead and do that. Do let me know in the comments ki kaisa chal raha hai. Have you been able to solve all the problems or not? Okay, whichever book you may follow, go ahead, solve the examples or unsolved problems from that textbook. Okay, try to match the answers. So yes, that was all for today. I'm going to see you again with a new method now. Macaulay's is over. So the methods which are left are the superposition method. It's a boring method, let me tell you very frankly. Then we've got the moment area method. But moment area method is very interesting, but it also has certain limitations. Then you've got the strain energy method. These are the three methods which I'll be discussing in the upcoming lectures. Don't worry, all of that is going to follow very soon. So guys, that was all for today. I'm going to see you again in the next video. Until then, take care, have a nice day, keep learning, keep watching. Thank you.